In their way is a former terrier, however, as Sam Allardyce looks to inspire the Toffees and bag himself another contract at Goodison Park with a strong end to the season. The town faithful will be hoping his players are already on the beach though, with Everton likely to snag a top-half finish after a disappointing start to the campaign. Ahead of the match we spoke to the Liverpool Echo's Sam Carroll to get his thoughts on Everton, Huddersfield Town and the Premier League relegation scrap. Here's what he had to say. What's the atmosphere like at Goodison Park at the moment? Are the fans happy with Sam Allardyce? Despite the 1-0 victory over Newcastle United papering over the cracks in midweek, Evertonians are not happy with Sam Allardyce, at all. The manager, from the outside, has come in, steadied the ship and secured their place in the Premier League ahead of next season. From the inside, however, Allardyce's brand of stagnant, percentage-based football has quickly grew wearisome on Merseyside. Evertonians will always support their club, and both home and away attendances are still packed to the rafters. How many of those fans want Allardyce to remain in charge, though? I'm not sure it's too many. It's almost like the club should release a survey asking them. If Huddersfield take control of this game on Saturday, expect the away fans to turn on the manager. Sam Allardyce poses for a photo after being unveiled as Everton FC boss at Finch Farm. How are the team playing currently? Are they still producing performances despite not having much to play for? Again, looking in from the outside, Everton aren't actually doing that bad. They've lost one of the last six, against champions-elect Manchester City, and have won away at Stoke City and drew at home to Champions League finalists in waiting Liverpool. But the manner of each performance has been dour. The Toffees scraped past 10-man Stoke, allowed Liverpool reserves to live comfortably until the final 10 minutes when the players realized they were allowed to attack and were pressed hard by an awful Swansea City side. The win over Newcastle was an improvement at times, but again, Theo Walcott's goal was our only shot on target. I'd love to say Everton are going to roll up to the John Smith Stadium and attack from the first whistle, but I can't see it happening. Who is in the best form at the minute and who will Town have to watch out for? Sadly, our best player this season has been, by a country mile, Jordan Pickford. The only reason Everton aren't in the same position as Huddersfield is down to our goalkeeper, and for all the transfer misgivings of last summer, the £30 million paid to Sunderland for his services is an absolute snip. Looking further afield, Walcott has looked reinvigorated at Goodison so far, but can drift in and out of games at times. Pace will definitely cause problems, while Yannick Bolasie is becoming the frustrating but somehow magic man for the Blues. His touch, erratic dribbling skills and poor decision-making have made him an easy target for Evertonians at times, but he also has a knack of creating something special. He's contributed to goals against Stoke, Man City, Brighton. Also expect Sanctosin to have a point to prove. The £27 million man hasn't found the back of the net since that snowy win in the Potteries despite some consistently decent performances. The day Everton FC boss Sam Allardyce went berserk for Huddersfield Town. What's your prediction for the match? As a Blue born exactly 1 month after we lifted the FA Cup, I always expect the worst when it comes to Everton. Huddersfield's jubilant celebrations after Tom Ince's late winner against Watford last time out make me think we'll be facing a confident terrier side, and it wouldn't surprise me if Sam seen a draw is a good point. My prediction is 1-1, which I'm not sure would really benefit either side. Do you think Huddersfield will stay up? Who do you think will go down? With Man City having secured the title and Chelsea losing ground on the top four, the relegation battle has fast become the most exciting loose end in the Premier League. Several weeks ago David Wagner's men were plummeting at an alarming rate, but that Ince goal could be worth a lot of money come the end of the season. With Stoke at Anfield this weekend and Southampton looking poor, I think the Terriers need just one more victory to stay up. I hope it doesn't come against Everton this weekend, but I do think you'll avoid the drop. Who doesn't love an underdog defying the odds? For me, the bottom three will stay unchanged: West Bromwich Albion, Stoke City and Southampton, come the end of the campaign.